Okay. Let us move to the second point. Okay. The second point, in order to maintain a good relationship between husband and wife. I'll summarize a long course that sometimes we deliver it in 2 or 3 days, or recently I recorded 72 episodes for Peace TV. 72 episodes for marriage divorce. And I have to leave, otherwise we could have continued up to 100 episodes. Yeah, marriage and divorce. It's such a vast topic, an important topic. I will summarize it in the following, maybe, 15 minutes. But let us see, if we can summarize it. Brothers and sisters, now, in order for the marriages to continue successfully, we need to understand what does the husband need from his wife, and what does the wife need from her husband. Are you following this? Okay. Tayyip. You are here. How many are married? How many people are married here? Raise your hands. Not many? Less than 40%? Tayyip. How many people are unmarried? And there are people who did not raise their what is this? Unspecified
students. They are students.
Huh?
They are students.
They are students? They are not married. Or what? They should say that they are not married.
Engaged.
Or,
engaged.
Yeah, but unmarried. Five. Okay, maybe 50-50. Okay. And it makes a big difference in terms of, I have done this survey number of times. Yeah? When you ask married people and when you ask non-married people. Okay. Okay. Now, here we have the brothers. By the way, does anyone or can anyone communicate with the sisters? I understood that there are sisters.
Yes. Yes.
Can you communicate with them?
Yeah.
So let us see any hands or something. Okay. Now for brothers, as husbands, what do you want from your wives? As a husband, what are, let us summarize it by, what are the most important qualities that you look, for in your wife, or you want from your wife?
Respect.
Respect. Quick, brothers, are you thinking you are not going to pass or fail an exam?
Love.
Peace.
Look after your children.
Look after your children.
You want a dinner and iron clothes.
To iron your clothes. This is what you want from your wife. Only.
Other things as well, but
the most important thing is to iron your clothes.
I said hot dinner.
Hot dinner is the most important thing you want from your wife.
Yes.
Hot dinner. Is this the most important thing you want from your wife?
Yes. Listening.
Companion.
Listening. Companion.
Passionate. Gratefulness.
Shukr, gratefulness,
yeah.
Okay. Compassion. Tayyip. What else? Tayyip. Support. Okay.
Sam'an
wa ta'a. Tayyip.
Honesty.
You know, Arabs, they don't mess around, yeah. Tayyip. What do men or husbands need from their wives? Okay, I'll summarize it. Men, they need 2 things from their wives. Yeah, sisters, please listen. Okay? One thing which is common, the husband wants from his wife and the wife wants from her husband. One thing that is common. Yeah, and both sides, they need it from each other. Which is what?
Security.
Respect.
Security.
Understanding.
You need from your wife security. You need it from your wife. Yeah, well, the wife needs security from the husband, but not the husband.
Yeah?
When they are sleeping, upstairs and they hear some noise downstairs, darling, go on, check. Yeah, what is happening there? She needs to provide him security. See, the common thing, brothers and sisters, is اللهم صل على محمد would showing love. Yeah, showing love, not love, showing love. Does that make sense? What is the difference between love and showing love? You have to express it. Yeah? Showing love is the closest thing to would. Allah Jalla wa Ala says in the Quran, وَمِنْ آيَاتِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنْفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً. He put between you what? مَوَدَّةً. مَوَدَّةً is what? Is showing love. Not really love. What does that mean? It is a very fundamental point. Please listen to this carefully. If you love your wife, but you can't express your feelings to her, it doesn't work. Agree or not? Okay, maybe we need to ask sisters like this. Okay, if your wife loves you, but she does not express this to you, does it work with you, brothers? Does it work with you?
No.
Okay. So, I need to see love. What is in her heart, it is a secondary issue. But I need to see love from her. She needs to see love from me. Yes? A man came to Umar ibn al-Khattab and he said to him, I don't love my wife. Umar ibn al-Khattab does not accept anyone to mess around. He was about to Yani hit him. And he said, listen, do you think that all those people love their wives? Yeah? Do you think that all these people love their wives? He said, people live together because of two things, because of Islam and because of what? Lineage. Yani lineage means what? The person is married to his wife because of her family, because of his children, because of other reasons, he will what? He will not divorce her. Yeah? He will say, haram, this is my wife. I have my children, she's the mother of my children, or she is the daughter of this man. She had a very good family. Okay? This is the right person, the person who thinks, in the Islamic way, in the right way. Or he will say, as it happened with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wanted to divorce Hafsa, or divorce her, according to different narrations. Jibril, the angel Jibril, came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, "Don't divorce her." Or the other narration, "Bring her back." Why? Because she is what? Anyone knows? Sawamatun qawama. She fasts frequently and she does what? Qiyamul layl, and she will be your wife in Jannah. Yeah? So, this Western notion that life is based on love is not true. That's why they are suffering from family breakdown. Because it cannot be there. Yeah? And, okay, as I always say to people, your neighbor, you might hate him, okay, for whatever reason. Are you going to say to him, whenever you see him, oh, such disgusting person. Such a disgusting person. I really hate you. Are you going to say this to him? Why?
Because he's your neighbor.
Because he is your neighbor. First of all, you just want to live in peace with him. Agree or not? So if you want to live in peace with him, what are you going to say?
Nice things.
Yes, nice things. So you meet him. Oh, how are you? Good morning. How are things? How's the children? Internally, you might hate to say these things, but this is life. This is life. This is not hypocrisy, by the way, brothers. Right? Leave the Western non-Islamic notion. Leave it aside. Real love, we will see it in Jannah. Yeah? We are living in dunya. Dunya is what? طيب وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور. Yes? This dunya is, as Allah جل وعلا said, is a test. طيب؟ خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم. Is a test. طيب؟ Real love and this, يعني, this romantic relationship, we'll find it in Jannah. Okay, brothers and sisters. طيب. So, if my wife loves me, and whenever I enter home, she doesn't smile, she doesn't welcome me. I traveled for 10 days and she did not miss me. And then I said, darling, I've been away for 10 days. She said, I really missed you. Why didn't you say this? I don't know. Come on, darling. Wallahi, I love you. Where is this love? Are you following, your brothers? Yeah. Same thing. Yeah? I am rude to my wife all the time. And then she said to me, I had enough with you. You don't love me. No, no, darling. Wallahi, I love you. What do you want with this love? You've been rude to me. You are shouting. You stop me from doing this and that. And then you claim that you love me. I don't want this love. Are we following this? Yeah? So this is one thing. That what? If you have love, but you don't show it, it doesn't work. Now, the opposite. If you don't have love, but you show love, it will work. Agree or not?
Yes.
Do you agree or not?
Yes.
If you don't love a person, but you show him love, does it work or not?
Yes.
The minimum is what? That you will live with him in peace. Agree? Like your neighbor, you hate him. Yeah, he hates you. But at least let us what? Live together in peace. Yes? Not only that, believe me, my brothers and sisters, love comes and goes. Love comes and goes. طيب. And the nature of the human being from a psychological perspective, and no one understood this except Islam. This is the Islamic theory, that you cannot have separation between the three powers of the human being. What are the three powers of the human being? The physical power, the intellectual power, and the spiritual power. طيب, the three powers. In Islam, you cannot separate between them because this is the reality of a human being. Are you following this?
Yeah.
This is the nature of a human being. Okay, for example, a friend of mine, he's in top in psychiatry, and he said to me, well, I was talking to him about this, the nature of the Islamic understanding of this. He said that is absolutely true. For example, anger. What do you call anger? A physical activity, or a spiritual activity, or an intellectual activity?
Different stages.
Anger.
Three, right?
What is it?
All of them.
Yeah. When you become angry, this is what, initially, it is what? A spiritual one. But your face becomes red, صح? So it has a physical impact. Agree or not? Yeah? And you mentally become disturbed. Agree or not? طيب? Yeah? And I remember I took a course, NLP course. Yeah, neuro language programming. Don't say that this means that it is halal or yeah, because there is a discussion about these courses. طيب. The instructor, may Allah have rahmah on him. His name was Ibrahim Faki from Egypt, one of the leading people. Yeah, in this field. He died 2 years ago, 3 years ago. His flat was burned in Egypt, طيب, in Cairo. Anyway, he was very, very intelligent person. He had some books, I don't know if you have come across those books. He said what Ibn Taymiyyah said maybe 600-700 years ago. He used to give us an example. He said, stand up, raise your hand. Yeah? And for example, my name is Haytham. Say, my name is Haytham and I am strong. And the other person will try to put my hand down. Yeah? My name is Haytham and I am strong. What happens, and if we have time, we could have done this exercise. Psychologically, I resist when this person is trying to put my hand down. Yeah? Now, okay, if I say, my name is Saeed and I am weak, and I'm raising my hand and the person is trying to put my hand down, my name is Saeed and I am weak, what will happen? The guy will put my hand down easily. This is an exercise, a very simple exercise that means a lot. What does that mean, brothers? What does it mean? What does
mentally,
this example?
Mentally.
Mentally is reflected on what?
Physically.
Physically and spiritually. Are you following it, this? When you say to your wife, you are such yani, a hateful lady, and you keep repeating this, you will hate her. Yeah? But if you hate your wife, imagine that you hate your wife, or the wife hates her husband, but every time he comes, or every time you come to your wife, you say, okay, let me leave hatred for a while now, and let me buy a present for her. And when I meet her, I say, I lie. I said to her, Wallahi, I love you. I really missed you. I was waiting for the time to come back to you. Yeah? And you keep repeating this. What will happen? You will love her. Same thing with the, from the wife to the husband. Are you following your brothers? Yeah? In the Quran, Allah Jalla wa Ala says, وَقُلْ لِعِبَادِي يَقُولُ الَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَنْزَغُ بَيْنَهُمْ. Tell my slaves to choose what? The best words. Why? Because the shaitan is putting what? Hatred between them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described the ladies of the Jannah, the best ladies. He said, وَإِذَا نَظَرَ إِلَيْهَا what? سَرَّتْهُ. If he looks at her, he will what? He will be happy. Happy not because she's pretty. By the way, for the non-married people, they think equality number one of wives is what?
Beauty.
Beauty. So, attraction. But for married people, they know that attraction will end up within how many? Newly married people. Where are the newly married people? Within what?
Gone after a week.
1 month.
A week? Can I announce this? Is your wife there?
Of course you can announce, you're all right. She'll see the video.
90 days. Within a week. Or within?
Yeah.
Not a year, Wallah. It doesn't last for a year. And then what? What beauty will remain?
Her
manner. Character. Manner. Yeah? We say in Arabic, Al-Jamal, Jamal what? Al-Ruh. Al-Jamal, the real Jamal, is Jamal what? Al-Ruh, the Jamal of the soul. Means, what is Ish Damha Khafif Ish? When is Sheikh Abdul Samad, Allah Yassir Amru? Jamal al-Ruh, Jamal al-Ruh means, she's a lovely lady. Lovely lady, she's smiling. Welcoming, forgiving, yeah? Caring. Yes? This is the kind of lady, that's why the Prophet ﷺ said, تزوجوا in Hadith Ma'qil ibn Yasar. When a man went to the Prophet ﷺ and he said, I want to marry this lady, she's barren, she doesn't conceive. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, don't marry her. The next time, the Prophet ﷺ said, don't marry her. Third time, the Prophet ﷺ said, marry what? Al-Wadud al-Walud. The one who is showing what? Love. Wadud. Yes? Wallahi, this is the most important quality for your wives. That she is what? Wadud. What does wadud mean? As the Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith, when you look at her, you what?
Feel happy.
You feel happy. Why? She's smiling. She has a cheerful face. She welcomes you. She waits for you. She shows you love. She tells you that she is missing you, etc. I hope that our sisters are listening. Tayyib? Yeah? Beauty can come and go within 1 week. Tayyib? Okay, 1 month, 1 year. But what remains is, as we say, Jamal al-Ruh. Yeah? She has a very nice personality, very loving, caring personality. Okay? We can talk a lot about this, but I'm worried about time. So this is the quality, this quality is common. Your wife needs from you this, and you need from your wife that. Obviously, my dear sisters, if we read the ahadith, we see that the Prophet ﷺ focused on this quality, yes, for sisters, for women. Right? So the focus on is more on women. Okay? But it needs to be done, or both sides, they need to show this. Right? And this is part of what Allah Jalla wa Ala says in the Quran, وَعَاشِرُوهُنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. Deal with them in kindness. And on the other ayah, Allah Jalla wa Ala says, وَلَهُنَّ مِثْلُ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. They have, or for them is what they have, for them is what it is upon them. Yeah? For them is what is upon them. Okay, brothers, sisters, so this is the first quality, right? Again, how to show this quality? Wallahi, sometimes very simple tools can mean a lot. Doctor, yes, agree? Yeah? Just simple things. Sometimes a message, a small message, right? A small message. A brother told me that, okay, as we are talking about marriage and divorce. A brother told me that he argues with his wife a lot, and his wife feels upset with him. Yeah, they came. And I told him, brother, first of all, do you want to continue in the marriage or not? And he said, yes, definitely. I asked the sister, do you want to continue in this marriage or not? And she said, yes. Then I told them about these points that I have mentioned to. Then I said to the brother, Akhi, when you upset your wife, do the following. Tayyip, do the following. Just go, yeah, and hug her and kiss her. Tayyip, not yani the sexual kiss, a kiss, okay? Although that is, yani, of course, husband and wife, we are not talking about something haram, mm-hmm. But the emotional one. Hug her and kiss her. And just do that. And let us see how things will develop. And he said, Wallahi, Sheikh, after some time, came maybe, and a few months later, I saw him by mistake. He did not come. And I said, how things are going? He came and he said, do you remember me, etc., etc.? I came to you, blah, blah, you advised me this. And he said, Wallahi, it worked, Sheikh. It worked. And it is like magic. We would have sometimes yani arguments, and I would really upset her. And I feel that she is upset. And after that, I just go to her and I say to her, sorry, hug her, kiss her. And as if I have wiped what I have done to her. I said, but don't abuse it. Don't abuse it, yani. Okay, now this is in order to fix your problems. Don't continue doing this. Yeah, make her upset and then just apologize. It doesn't work for a long time. But this is a very simple tool. It means a lot. Are you following here? Yeah, you have brothers? Right? Okay. So this is something common that both sides they need. Now something that the wife needs from the husband, yes? And something else that the husband needs from his wife. Okay. What is the second thing the husband needs from his wife after showing love? The first quality is showing love. What is the second one?
Respect.
Obedience. Yeah? They work hand in hand, by the way. Obedience. They work hand in hand. Okay? By obedience. The Prophet ﷺ said, yeah, if the lady or if the wife prays her five times and fast her Ramadan and that before that preserved her private part, yes, or her chastity, and وأطاعت زوجها. And if she obeys her husband, it will be said to her on the day of resurrection, enter Jannah from any gate you like. Enter Jannah from any gate you like. Allah Jalla wa'ala says, فَالصَّالِحَاتُ قَانِتَاتٌ حَافِظَاتٌ لِلَّهِ. قَانِتَاتٌ, yeah, قَانِتَاتٌ means they are obedient to Allah and obedient to what? To their husbands. Obedience. طيب, obedience. Okay, you might be the best wife, my dear sister, the best cook. You look after the children, etc., etc. But you are not obedient. Wallahi, there will be no peace at your house. It is clear. We don't want to get in. Yani, much. I'm worried about time. Now let us move to the wife. What does the wife want from her husband? First of all, we said what? She wants from him what?
Showing love.
Showing love. The second thing is what?
Money.
What is it? Yes. She needs from her husband what is called in the Quran, قوامه. Allah Jalla wa'ala described men. Yes? Allah Jalla wa'ala says by saying, على النساء بما فضل الله بعضهم على بعض. الرجال what? قوامون. What does قوامون mean?
Responsible.
Exactly. In charge. Responsible. Yeah? See, again, I have done many surveys asking sisters what do they want from their husbands. And they mention so many things, and when I summarize them, or sometimes when you write the survey in a particular way, to tell them about how they think, and all of them talk about what? Security. Wives need to feel what? Secure next to her husband. Security. Yeah, you mentioned it. Yeah? Security. Security, what does security mean? The first element of security is what? Emotional security. This is the top. Yes, this is the highest priority. Emotional, what? Emotional security. What does that mean? Emotional security means the husband is not torturing her. Yeah, emotionally. How? Yeah, she feels secure. She feels stable. She feels stable. She feels that the man is really a man and he is taking the burden of decisions. He's taking what? The burden of decisions. All what she needs to do is to execute his decisions. She doesn't want to take the blame. She doesn't want to be stressed with, okay, taking decisions. Yeah? She needs to feel that his decisions are, in most cases, the right decisions. So what? Your wife needs what? Security. To feel secure. The first element of security is what? Emotional security. The second element is what?
Financial
security. الرجال قوامون على النساء بما فضل الله بعضهم على بعض وبما أنفقوا من أموالهم. طيب, if this security is there, believe me, your wife will be relaxed. And by the way, I always say to brothers and sisters, wallahi, women can do marvelous jobs. They can even work harder than brothers. Yani, I look at my wife. She looks after, I have six children. She looks after six children. May Allah Jalla Ala preserve them and preserve your children. She cooks, she cleans, she does so many things. She works as a secretary for me. She does so many things. And I am amazed how can she does all these things. Yeah? And she's multitasking. Right? Yeah? This is my wife because I know her. When I know my mother, she was the same thing. Right? Those are the mothers that I, yani, or the women that I mix with them. Okay? I know some of the relatives, the wives of my brothers, etc. Okay, I don't mix with them yani, directly, but I see what kind of jobs they do. They do marvelous jobs, unbelievable. But they don't bear it that you torture them, yeah, emotionally. Clear? Fine. We can talk a lot about this, but again, time. Now, so these are the two things that your wife needs from you. What? Showing love and
security.
Security. What do you need from your wife? Showing love and
obedience.
You as a husband do these two things, and you as a wife, yeah, do these things, khalas, marriages will what? Will continue, most likely, successfully. By the grace of Allah Jalla wa'ala, make a lot of dua, طيب, and Allah Jalla wa'ala will help you, inshallah, to maintain a good marriage, inshallah. My dear brothers, in particular, a message to the brothers and to sisters. I always say to them by the end of yani, a lecture like this, I say to them, go today, and maybe today, and especially yani, today is the weekend, yeah? Right? So go and try with your spouse just to say, let us open a new chapter where you do these things and I do these things in order to see how life will become. Yeah, may Allah Jalla Ala put love, yes, between us, and may Allah Jalla Ala forgive us for our shortcomings. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa barakatuh.